Now, final session, we will discuss the most important aspect of the model tax convention here. I will discuss about the permanent establishment concept and the differences between the OECD model and UL model tax convention. So let's focus to the end. PE concept is quite important, and the interpretation and implementing of tax treaty. So, well, in the Article 5 of the tax treaty, it has a very detailed definitions of the permanent establishment. As I told you at the third session, permanent establishment, whether you have the permanent establishment in the source country or not, there are different principles of the taxing principle of allocation of taxing right applies to the income. So it is really important to decide whether the certain company has the permanent, especially non-resident company, has the permanent establishment in the source country or not. So there's a lot of cases whether the certain company has the permanent establishment, and it is quite interesting sometimes. So Article 5, what is about the definition of the permanent establishment? What is the permanent establishment is defined in the Article 5, and key test which determines the right to tax the business profit in the source state is the existence of the permanent establishment, as I told you. And permanent establishment is also important in applying other articles, for example, the interest income or dividend income or the royalty income, or even in the Article 15 of the employment income. It depends on the existence of the permanent establishment differs the applying paragraph of each articles of 10, 11, 12, and 15. First one is the definition. For the purpose of this convention, the term permanent establishment means first fixed place of business and through which the business of the enterprise is wholly or partly carried on. So this definition has three important criteria. First, should be fixed. Second, should be a place. And third, certain activities should be carried through that place of business. And this is the essential criteria requiring the existence of the permanent establishment. So essential characteristic is the, as I told you, distinct situs, and should be a fixed one, and there should be a sufficient duration, which is related to the term fixed. So whether the PE, that is the acronym of the permanent establishment, PE exists, depends on the fact that place of business, if it is fixed, and business carried on through permanent establishment. or no, through fixed place of business. So condition one of PE is place of business. What is the place of business? Oh, well, the paragraph of the commentary, commentary of the para 4 of para on para 1 of the para 4 to 5.4 explains the condition of the business of place of business, which means that the that place means the premise, facility, or installation. So it doesn't have to be on land. Well, it should be used for carrying on business. And whether or not it is used exclusively for that purpose is not crucial. It's not important. However, it should be that space should be at enterprise's disposal. In other words, enterprise has to control over a space. That space, whether it is owned, it is not important. It is not important whether it is owned, rented, or borrowed. Well, the important thing is that that place of business should be at its disposal. Let's take the examples here that the, for example, a certain businessman takes the visit a place of clients and taking order every day. Taking orders every day, does it constitute the fixed place of business? Well, answer is no, because that businessman doesn't have a control over that place. It is right, this businessman visits this place very occasionally, from time to time, and it for quite a long time to take some orders. But this businessman doesn't have any control over this place. In that sense, this space is not the businessman's disposal. So in that case, it does not constitute the requirement of the place of business. Second, it should be a fixed one. Well, first one is duration test, and second one is location test. Location test means that this fixed place has some geographical spot. Has to be a geographical spot. First sub requirement of the second condition, sufficient duration. Well, in the model convention, OECD commentary, less than 6 months probably does not constitute PE. Well, if it endure, its duration is between 6 to 12 months, maybe it could constitute permanent establishment. If it is over 12 months, it is likely to constitute permanent establishment. And it doesn't have to be a regularly, it can be a regularly visited. So you don't have to make a visit permanently. It can be some interruptions between the visit to that place. And if the certain company moves to the new place, duration clock is set back to zero. For example, one place, certain company moves to another place here, definitely and distinctively, and the clock sets starts from zero again. So although it stays here 4 months and here 2 months, this location and this location does not do not constitute permanent establishment as far as the sufficient duration is concerned. And commencement and cessation of the permanent establishment is does not count the set of times. And when all the acts and measures connected with the formal activity of the PAR terminated are the cessation spot of the PE. And temporary, as I told you, temporary interruption of operation is not the closure. This is not the termination. This is not the termination. So let's take the example. This is the seasonal job, and one particular company visit this place here for 5 months, and during the monsoon time, they 5 months, and during the monsoon time, they stop their business for 2 months, and resume around and 4 months again. And these 2 months is not the the closure of the PE. So these whole months will be counted to constitute the duration of the permanent establishment. Second test of the, let me back to one. The condition of the, condition two of the PE is the fixed place of business. I explained to you first about the duration test, and second test is the location test. Should be that permanent PE has to have a geographical spot. So that location is the there should be a certain distinctive place here, and link, there should be a link between the place of business and specific geographical point. So, well, what is important here is that there should be some connections between the place and their businesses. For example, there is a paving enterprise. They are paving the roads here. They are digging up the lands and covering the concrete here. And this place is thought considered as the place of business because there is a link between their activity, which is paving the road, and the place where is the place the enterprise is working on is the place of paving that road or their activity. So well, in this case, this road does not have to be a narrow geographical point. In one day, they paved here, but the other day, they paved here. On the third day, paved here. But this kind of, this location is wholly, totally constitute the permanent establishment of the paving road company. However, if there's no distinct place, For example, website. Website, well, there should be a distinctive cyberspace, but there's no land or distinctive place in certain country. Website does not constitute permanent establishment. And it is possible that, for example, one consulting firm sends their consultants to the country S, and they stayed first in the downtown of country S first 2 months here in H Hotel, and next 3 months in L Hotel. Then these two are the separate, are calculated as separate one? The answer is no. Well, the duration test, in the location test, that location is coherently coherent. If this place are coherent whole, commercially or geographically, well, if they stay, the consultant of the consulting firm is staying 2 months here and 6 months here, although they are separate place, whole 8 months is calculated as a whole, and in this place are treated as the one place of fixed place of business. And second, it is same as the street market. In the street market, well, one enterprise can visit, here's the street market, one day, they stayed here in the first place, and stayed around 3 months, but there is a problem, so they decide to move their place around there. They stayed 9 months. Let's suppose that. And in that case, this whole area constitute the geographical spot of the permanent establishment. In that sense, well, this place should be considered as a coherent whole commercially and geographically. Third condition is that the place made and carried used for the business. So the third condition is that the enterprise has to carry on a business through the permanent establishment. So the connection between the place of business and the business itself should be made and should be existent, and that is the third condition of the permanent establishment. For example, here's the building, and painter of the foreign company visit here and drawing a picture. Let's say it is a bird, and it took about 2 years. In that case, well, because there is the connection between the painter's painting and this building itself can constitute the place of business. Will be a permanent establishment of the painter. But here in the painter case, painter has some connection with that place, and the painter has control over that place. That makes that building as the permanent establishment of painter. But in this case, there should not be a permanent establishment. Let's take the example that one transport company using in the delivery dock in the clients, they visit here in delivering dock for about 2 years. They loading and unloading their merchandise and carryings here. In this case, this delivery dock does not constitute place of business because they do is just using this place for delivering and their carriages. So in that case, this does not constitute the permanent establishment of the enterprise. So, the economy is becoming mobile and cyber. Many of the transactions are made cybernetically. So there are lots of discussions and debate on the definitions of the permanent establishment. Especially recurrent activities like activities needing a small space, needing only a very nominal space of the business, or some business doesn't need any space or place of business actually. So there are lots of discussions and debate how to define permanent establishment. As I told you, website is not considered as the place of business because this doesn't have any physical location in the source country. Still, by using website, many foreign countries are successfully carrying their business in the source country. So there are lots of complaints, especially coming from the source country, including the developing country. So, basically, definition of permanent establishment is now in the process of development. So you have to take care the development of the concept of the permanent establishment. Now, I'm coming to the final subject of our discussions. The difference between the OECD model and UN model. OECD model is tilted to the investing country. They put more importance on the residence country. UN model is more favorable to the taxing right of the source country. So in case of OECD country, in case of OECD model, this model are used mainly by developed country. In contrast to that, UN model are mainly used by developing country. As I told you, the UN model put emphasis on the taxing right of the developing country. So by that reasoning, it has more wider concept compared to the OECD model. For example, in the UN model, if certain construction activity lasts more than 6 months, it is considered to constitute permanent establishment. In compared to that, OECD model legislate that the construction site should last more than 12 months. Otherwise, there's no PE in the construction site. So basically, by applying more wider concept of PE, well, it can, the source country can perform more taxing rights on the income occurred in the source territory. And in case of UN model, it emphasizes on the existence of PE, where services are provided through the enterprise's employees or personnel. So there, well, especially in UN model, if a foreign country sends their employee to the certain company of located in our state as source country, well, it is emphasized in UN model that the permanent establishment is constituted by sending their enterprises and employee. However, the OECD model also think in that way. So the actual difference between two models are not so big, in my opinion. And delivery, maintenance of stocks, and insurance are the activities in the not constituting the PE in the OECD model. However, in UN model, this activity are also considered as constituting permanent establishment. And the third one, UN model is based on limited force of attraction. Here, OECD model, business income is taxable only through the permanent establishment. So by this part, is same as OECD model. However, the UN model also includes the activity which is same or similar kinds as those sold through that permanent establishment. And services and other business activities carried on in the source state of the same or kind, same similar kind of the activities. So in the UN model, although some activity is not carried through the permanent establishment, if it is similar or same activity as the PE, same activity that PE does, it is taxable in the source country. So this is the biggest difference between the source country in the of the UN model compared to the OECD model. UN model, because UN model applies the limited force of attraction rule, it is really easy S does not need to determine whether the particular activity are attributable to the PE, so it is easy to administer, and for the taxpayer, it is hard to avoid the taxation in the source country by using the permanent establishment, by avoiding the activity through the permanent establishment. However, at the same time, this principle is criticized to create uncertainty in respect in the view of the taxpayers and disincentive to invest in source country. And in the UN model, there is some limitation of the correlative adjustment in case of fraudulent or fraud or gross negligence in the TP, transfer pricing area. Transfer pricing will be covered by another professional, so he will talk about that in that session. And limited rate on interest and dividend is higher, so that the source country can have more taxing right compared to the residence country. And royalty, in case of royalty, UN model applies the limited taxation of the source country. On the contrary, OECD model applies the residence principle of taxation. So, and the taxing right of source country are conferred to in case of capital gains of shares, pension income, and high-level managers' income, and other income. So in those respect, well, the UN model has more has provided more taxing right of the source country. So this was all about the tax treaty, model tax convention of OECD and UN model. And I think I browse the important aspect of the model tax convention. And thank you for your attention. Thank you.